Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Newbies, turn to ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Night Stalker.
Newbies, turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Gyrocopter!
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Newbies, turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Seconds remaining. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Anti-mage.
Newbies, turn to pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Dragon Knight.
Epicenter Land Finals live here in Moscow. I'm Toby One. I'm joined here by the wonderful Purge, amen, as well as this beautiful Russian crowd.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. They have these wristband things. They keep lighting up. I don't know what it means, but it's awesome.
And they do it in sync. It's with the pulse, man. It's with the pulse. They got the finger on the pulse of Dota here in Russia.
At first, I thought it was about clapping or something like that, but I'm really excited to be here. It's going to be a great game. Awesome draft.
Yeah.
I'll see how it goes.
Yeah, looking forward to it. Can't wait to get into it. Of course, we get to see NewBee, the undefeated team so far. We're going to see if they are actually able to be defeated. A lot of people said OG there, out of all the teams who are attending this event, they're a team with the biggest chance to do it.
And I think this is a good draft to do it. They've got a very good roaming support, so NewB on their side, they've got very good rotating cores, and that's really what's going to change everything. How well can NewB use their Bounty Hunter to go around and create pressure in lanes, and how well can the level 6 cores, Dragonite, Gyrocopter, and Quap, rotate into lanes and get advantage?
We got our wonderful Channing crowd behind us. I gotta get used to this without us being able to hear the speakers influencing them.
I know that they can't listen to creepy things.
All the puns, everything that gets misheard. The sad, sad times of life.
That's right. At least like half the crowd will hear you screaming if there's an Enigma picked. You got that going for you.
That is very, very true until they start screaming even louder. Wow, Hal, are you really going to be doing this against Moon on the top lane? He's actually dissing the lift of Ed. Speaking of that, Moon picked up right now. The Tango bait has actually worked enough to at least drop Moon down by 2/3 of his life. He actually dropped his own shield on the crowd just to say the same thing back to you. You want to play mind games with me? I'll play mind games with you.
He's not phased at all. Actually, his regen is ridiculous. He's got 4.7 right now. The Night Stalker buffs, man.
It's like the Nyx is what, the only other one who's better than that?
Yeah, something like that. Axe, I think, is pretty high as well recently. But yeah, OG's got to get control of their lanes a little bit, then they have to rotate their supports around getting kills, and they've got the great heroes for doing this.
Oh, KP, Crit, Fly, they're both going to walk into him as KP. He's got Blink available anyway.
Okay.
So it looks like he's not really that phased, but this offlane Queen of Pain, like, it's not something we're on, like, I don't say it's common of late, but it's something which I think we've seen a lot of in the past, at least.
I think maybe he was trying to move down to block, body block the small camp perhaps, assuming that the supports would be in the lane, prepped there. But yeah, he runs uphill, no chance of him dying though. And Ring of Protection, he's actually not going to trade super well with the Phoenix here, especially when Earth Spirit eventually gets here. But for now, Quap's going to do her best scale level 2, and Earth Spirit's going to try to go mid.
I want to keep my eyes up on this top lane a little bit more, mainly just because it's a combination where you expect a little bit more damage to come out. Maybe once Hal hits his level 3 and you get those 2 points up in Rocket Barrage, and Chorn also has his level 3 with the Fate Bolt, they might be able to find a kill over a Moon, but there's something which OG I kind of like about all their lanes. They're very difficult to kill. You've either got Blink Escape, you can have Viper who will have Corrosive Skin up soon with a huge creep wave coming underneath his own tower, so he's going to get levels. And then you got a Nightstalker who's just like innately tanky on that offlane.
And he completely read that Bounty was going to be there. There's a Sentry mid, but they haven't seen him yet once, so it's got to be tough. So he got some levels there, he backed off, said I haven't seen Bounty yet, and no point in dying now, especially after those taunts, man. He's got to play it safe. And yep, the amount of regen he's got, he's only used one Tango in this lane so far.
It's the dream middle lane, a little bit of a boulder going over towards Moo. It's just harassment more than anything else, as you combine up both points of toxicity, aka one coming out from the Orb of Venom and the second coming out from Viper. Even then, he's actually multitasking that too.
But this is a
Dragon Knight mid. Like, this is what Newbee's been playing all the time, right? Because it just survives any kind of initiation.
Every team plays this mid right now. It's very strong. The earlier draft is actually looking a bit weird since they did leave a lot of strength heroes off, a lot of supports banned. But it's always going to be strong. But except for maybe this game, because OG has Phoenix.
Top lane, Moon, a little bit of trouble. Chuan still got his lift available, so they're going to pick up Moon, dropping him down. How the Rocket Barrage. Moon, the creep wave soaks up so much of it, he's making a break for the Wild Wings. Wants to be denied, but it will not happen. The Gyrocopter reaches him, actually triggering the flat cannon at the last moment. So he's able just to reach him before he gets to the neutral camp.
It was a very small thing, but Rubik, Chuan there made a super sick play. He actually threw him away from the creeps, because he knew that Rocket Barrage damage maximizes there. Normally you throw him as far away as possible from the tower, but that kept him away from the neutrals where he would have denied himself, and it maximized the Rocket Barrage damage. Super sick play from Chuan.
We expect nothing else from him. This is the reason why OG banned the line in the other face KP. Bottom lane, KP, he can't blink himself out. He could deny it by the neutral!
Oh my god, it was such a sick play too. Crit got silence level 2. They had the damage, but he happened to pull the neutrals over.
Oh!
That's so unfortunate for OG here.
This is the kind of stuff that you gotta just put your brain back into play and just don't lose it.
Yeah.
Oh!
They'll have more chances at kills, but that's gonna be a pretty big offset there. Viper on the mid lane's got an Aqua picked up already, so he's got great last hitting power, good harass power as well.
I'm actually wondering, like, how this lane's meant to progress. Like,
Which lane? You have mid lane,
where you have the Viper. Do you want to see Notel going in for early utility? You pick up that mech, and then you look to OG to fight a little bit more as a group underneath, like a Phoenix timing.
They're going to be doing fairly similar stuff, except Newbee's more of a 5-man draft. OG's more of a 4-man. If Viper gets a mech and he's quite tanky with decent damage, all they have to do is back him up with Sunray. If he gets overcommitted, then they Sunray him. He gets healed, and Phoenix does damage to another core that Viper's fighting. So they're going to be quite strong in the mid game with just their 4, and in the meantime, Miracle will hopefully do 9k MMR things.
Moon. Be careful how long he hangs around. Chuan's going to come down again too, so they can attack him. With that level 2 on Bounty, that means they have the extra Janata. There's your pickup. Throw it back again. He has a lot of creep to work through. Fly kind of still in cooldown for one more second. House are too healthy, but now you see him. He was about to do it again. But it'll be Karka who gets the last hit. And this is now 2 kills going the way of Newbee.
Yeah, they've been getting so much advantage out of the Bounty Hunter here. I almost wonder if OG should have had a Sentry in the offlane, because if they did, they would have seen it.
Bottom lane, KP initiated. This time there is no creep in range for denial, and the perfect kick timing from Crit allows Miracle to swipe in an attack. So finally, that safe laner of OG is able to find himself a kill.
That was a huge kill. Only downside is that Crit needs mana, but he's going to suicide to do this. Find items. Yep, he's going to suicide now. It's much faster than walking all the way back. Maybe another gank on Moon here?
Moon this time is being a little bit more cautious, and
he could die here.
He's pretty low, but yeah, he's got an invis room bottled up. He's fine.
Up an infused raindrop really early here, just so he can breathe fire more often, and Viper can't do that many magic nukes to him. Once he gets Viper Strike, maybe a different story though.
You want a nuke to come? Crit's rotating into that mid lane. As far as vision goes, they don't see it, so there's your run in into the sun ray. Moo, well, the kick is, well, where is it coming? Karka makes his way in. All 3 get kicked, but Moo's still alive. Finally, the dive will come out from Fly. Find the kill, but the pickup from Chuan, grabbing Fly mid-flight. Notel still wants to retreat out this one, too, so it'll end up being a 1-for-1 trade-off. Phoenix for a DK mid-solo, you'll take that any day if you're OG.
That was incredible how much damage he took, but that's because he got 2 infused raindrop procs. It stopped almost all the nuke from Earth Spirit, and he almost lived. And that's really the story of what Newbee does. They survive their lanes, but they get rotations from Queen of Pain or Gyrocopter, and they're going to get return kills. If they can keep doing this 1-for-1 trade, it's okay for Newbee.
They want to go again on mid. Karkar is hoping that Notel is going to come slightly out of position.
Oh, the raindrop.
With the Breathe Fire, then they go for the Dragon Tail stun. Chuan with a pickup. He's got mana, however, to let that Fade Ball go. And with the Viper Strike, Chuan, they're going to have to deny him here underneath the tower. And, well, oh yeah, you can't do it. Yeah. So it's going to be a 1-for-1 trade-off, but still the Viper dice first.
Yeah, one of the few remaining confusing mechanics is that not all poison attacks let you deny, and Vipers certainly don't. So he does get a return kill, at least for him. It's not terrible. They did just kill Dragonite, so a good start. And the infused raindrops did buy him some time there and allow him to kill Chuan. Absolutely worth it.
Now, OG, they're rotating so heavily. I'm almost like, it almost feels like what Newbee was doing during our group stages, where you're just moving everywhere across the map, always adding pressure, no lane feels safe. And that's why, yep, they jump in on Hal Chuan with a pickup. Crit throwing back, gets a little stun on Fly, so he can't keep the pressure going. But now in comes Moo, the rotation, looking for the trade. Moon into the tree line. Now he's going to tick down. Thanks to that Dragon Knight, that ulti. Crit, no ult, so he's going back. They can't get back past the tower. Moo with a double kill.
That was sick from Dragon Knight to be set up for that. He anticipated the rotation for being there, so he actually got there in time. Although it was a big mistake from Crit, he accidentally forgot to put a boulder down when he did his rolling, and it ended up with Moon having to go deeper into towards the tower, and he got punished because of it.
Mid lane.
They can't make these mistakes.
No tell. Can they actually... Well, how? He's not level 6 yet. They can just give Hal a little bit more space and then have cooldown. Potentially, they could then go on no-tail, but they can't do it.
The rotations, though, are pretty important. Even if some people are dying...
Speaking of...
Crit's just a little bit off the mark here. Missing his silence there. I don't think he was going to die either way. Well, maybe. Miracle could have mana burned ulti'd. Yeah, actually, I think that was a kill. Honestly, if he got that silence off, Quap was already missing a lot. All they had to do is like 2 hits, a stun, and a AM ulti, and that was a dead offlane. So they're just missing a couple kills here, and that one wouldn't have been punishable.
Top lane, they're going to try and punish Fly with that Observer Ward already on the hillside. They perfectly see where Fly is moving, preparing to attack in from behind. Fly, he does still have Icarus Dive available, and they don't have themselves a good stun like you have with Rubick Telekinesis. All you've got a Shuriken toss and projectiles like that will not really interrupt the Phoenix.
He can predict this as well because Dragonite's pushing the lane. He's 6, he's going to have his ult in a bit, and clearly the Gyro hasn't been anywhere in a while. They haven't seen him mid. Bounty Hunter could be anywhere, and this is usually the time when players realize, this is
look
very
at the ping.
Clear. There's obviously going to be heroes at the secret shop. They're not even going to bother scanning. They just know that they're there. And as soon as he leaves, they move right in and say, well, that was obvious.
Yeah.
They're rotating around. They sat there forever. And in the meantime, OG's taking mid as fast as possible.
Yep. And both teams, like, this almost feels like a same kind of objective thing. You push into a tier 1 tower. You establish vision a little bit further behind it. OG put the ward up on top of the hill, watching towards the Radiant secret shop. While OG, they put a ward behind the tower. This kind of helps them out a little bit more, so they know if someone does just slip in behind or they bring in more support. However, they cannot see Karka. Crit is going to move down. Karka's actually staying with him. It's going to be a little bit of harass. KP's on the way, and he does have Sonic Wave, but Like, Kaka can't keep him controlled that long.
Well, they did pretty good damage to the mid tower. It's not terrible trade considering you're against a Dragon Knight, but I think Viper is just going to try to sit here mid and defend this as long as possible. They don't want to lose all of their towers. The offlane one, not a huge deal. But for now, I think OG's happy with how the game's going.
He's being initiated on. Karkos here. Crit jumps in. Look at the TPs. Newbee are bringing everybody. Moo will go down with the extra Sunray. Squad! He's burning inside the Sunray. No Tail will survive a little bit longer. It's a double kill for No Tail. Al's cooldown didn't do enough.
He had a 10-stick wand. He could have lived and maybe killed the bounty as well, but he didn't press it in time. And that might have bought him more time for another infused raindrop to go.
Bottom lane, KP going to be initiated on. Moon, he's got the initial silence. They burn off a lot of the mana. KP can't blink out, not when the mana void's there. 7-7 now on the board. I was actually a little bit concerned that OG supports were actually falling behind in levels in the experience game. They were sitting at 4 before these engagements began, and now they just start to skyrocket.
That's the best thing about what they're doing. Even if they're getting kills and dying afterwards, they're always getting experience. So while it's kind of bad that it's not just leading to kills, every time their supports get levels, and they can do this while creating pressure on lanes. So that's what's so cool about Newbee's draft. They can always TP quap and do a blink scream and usually pick somebody up. And these infused raindrops up on the tanky heroes, it always buys them an extra second or two, minimum.
Newbee's looking to go for the next objective. Normally when they do this, it's like it's straight from one tier one tower to another, and then you force the fight, they try and take the better advantage in the fight. But you notice also the build coming up. Oh, how? Okay, they trigger dust. You can say goodbye to that gyrocopter. The cooldown or no cooldown, there's no support there to really help him out. In fact, now Miracle, with that early Vanguard on him, is very willing to dive underneath the tier one towers. KP's hanging around, he's got Sonic Wave, he can hit 4 heroes right now, but there's no real follow-up. Fly is the only one, but he's also got Nova. Chuan, he's gonna steal Blink Kaka. Now the Nova is gonna be triggered. Moo, they focus down the Nova, so fly down very quickly, but the kick catches out both KP as well as Moo, allowing Miracle to turn around, but then the Dragon Tail stuns there. Sonic Wave is still available, so Newbee still have high amounts of damage. Damn Chuan, he's got so many levels also. He's just removing all the damage. They track on No Tail. They want the kill. Kaka has to back out. He doesn't have a lot of life. And now Viper Strike stolen by Chuan. He might have the mana. Miracle can hit him again. Or I can just blow him up with the mana void. Moo tries to send his ground. Magnetize makes it very difficult. There's your Sonic Wave spilling out from KP. He waited long and will pause the game. As there is a small moment here from Newbee where things aren't right. Moo is about to go down. Miracle and Moon will guarantee that. And KP is also not in a great position either. No blink available for 12 seconds. No Tail should have that one in the bag.
It might have been a problem with Rubick there. I think he paused because he stole Viper Strike, but I didn't see it fly out. I mean, he got bursted pretty rapidly.
Yep.
Maybe it was something like that, but he should be able to throw the Viper Strike out instantly, and they're going to get 2 kills out of this. So
yep.
That could have been an extra kill on OG. I wouldn't be surprised. I've had similar issues, and if Chuan uses Legacy or something like that, those Rubick bugs, they do pop up sometimes.
Chuan is old school enough that he may actually use that. Now Snoopy here are in a rough position. The roughest they've been. Well, maybe not this entire tournament, but still, it's 2k worth of net worth behind and 2.5k worth of experience. OG looking solid, and that mech from No Tail's arriving up shortly. So, yep. With Vanguard on the Anti-Mage, Miracle fighting earlier on, a mech completed as well, OG's got so much sustain.
Yeah, he's going to farm as fast as a Battle Fairy normally does, just because he's going to be in fights and it's going to go well. This is the build that he did when he hit 9k MMR. That's why this is so awesome. Vanguard into Vlad's. He's got ridiculous HP. He doesn't have to get as many stat levels either, because now he's got all this extra HP and damage by being able to grab mana break levels. So, it's kind of a cool build, and it'll amplify all of his team's damage. It's going to give them all an extra 4 armor plus more mana, so much better for battling early as Anti-Mage.
Well, if they can battle toe-to-toe with Newbee, but Newbee, we still have to remember when they run this strat with the DK, they're always looking to bring down the buildings, they're always looking to bring down the tier 1 towers, and right now they still haven't lost a single tier 1, but OG, if they can find themselves a pick and then push through, they look like they're going for the mid lane.
Well, they smoked under a ward is the problem. They smoked next to their sentry. Kind of a little bit of a weak place to send. They weren't going to find much there, but they didn't get the prediction. That means Newbee knows where they're at. They did also use a scan in their jungle, anticipating Newbee is pressuring their tier 1, which is what was happening. So tier 1's going to go down, but they get a mid tower, and they're going to keep pushing mid. What was that sound? I missed it.
It's the Russian commentators trying to get on the PA system. They're having a couple of problems at the moment.
Oh, okay.
That's why the crowd is doing what they're doing and why we seem a little unsettled. Tier 2 tower now being pressured in the mid lane. The tracks are being prepped on both Miracle as well as No Tail. A refresh over Miracle. Chuan, what can he steal? Of course, is Viper Strike every single time.
It's pretty good. It's about 300 damage. It's mostly good for the slow, though. 40% slow for 5 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
It's about a level 4 nuke.
Moo. He really wants to come forward. With the armor up, it's good, but without the dragon form,
yeah,
it's not really the fight that Newbee want to take. They rely more on how to do something. He turns on the flat cannon, so at least they can clean up the creep wave. And OG can't pressure this any more forward.
Yeah, they've got to get out. I mean, OG has really good heroes for dealing with armlet. Almost all the heroes don't do physical. It's basically just anti-mage, really. So yep. Viper's doing almost all magic damage with some physical components. Same thing with Earth Spirit and Phoenix. Pure damage and magic. They have good solutions to DK, so Newbee has to take these fights perfectly, otherwise they're going to get crushed.
Oh, OG. Oh, they're just staring down Hal. Like, you fly the kick out, but Hal is too far away. And this is the last tier 1 tower now that OG has standing. Of course, they do have the big advantage, the fact they were able to bring down the tier 1 tower in the mid and do significant damage to the tier 2 tower. But it's like, can you even get more with this? Like, your lineup is going to get more eventually.
Well, OG's mean, you mean, right?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, OG's going to get more.
Like, Newbee's lineup was great for defending the laning stage, and they're good for doing tower pushes because they have Dragonite to take towers and Gyro to sit behind him. But the damage types of OG are just so much better right now. It's so scary for Newbee to fight. It only goes well if they get a great cooldown and a great quap ult. That's the only way. Their team fight's not as good, and OG has the better damage matchups.
Is that when you look to not team fight? You look to actually, like, predict the OG move and hatch out two heroes when they're out of position?
Well, they're not really splitting up that much, though. I mean, Miracle's still gonna farm relatively fast, not as good as with Battle Fury, obviously.
Crit's probably gonna be the best opportunity right now. Chuan, okay, he does not. He puts down the Observer Ward and then blinks away instantly. Crit puts down his own Observer Ward, but there's a lot of movement on the way. Kaka is in the neighborhood. Chuan, there's your pickup. They turn on the Sun Ray. Hao is here, and let the Rock of Mirage go. Chuan is just burning. Crit so low, but he's still surviving through all of this. He can boulder in a moment. No, in comes Mo. Look for these track heals, however. Newbee want the advantage, but they're not going to find it. Miracle's on the front lines. Moon didn't die, and Fly got the Nova off. Now the Shuriken Toss can finally get something back, but Mo, he's got to get it out of the sun. Fly gets himself a double kill. They're looking for more, and with the Dust Trigger, they're going to find it. Kaka, Shuriken Toss will not save you. A triple kill for the Phoenix.
Dude, OG is completely doing this. Their draft is so good for what Newbee is picking, and they're able to gank so well in the early game that even with Newbee's rotations, they were still getting even trades. And those even trades pushed their two amazing supports and a great team fight, which is where Bounty definitely struggles. He got some great shurikens off there, but it's not the same as two Sun Rays and a Supernova. It's just not even close. And now Fly's got a Midas. So they're just accelerating past where Newbee is going to be.
This is the dream right now if you're OG. A great start against a team which was undefeated. 29 games, I think we're up to?
Yes.
Straight for Newbee?
That's the problem, though. When you go undefeated in the group stage and every team fears you, that's the only person that you study. Or it's the person you spend 80% of your time on. I guarantee that every top team here says, we got to figure out how to beat Newbee because we're going to have to play them eventually.
Mm-hmm.
And they have put thought into this. It's very clear by their drafting. They bait Newbee into the bounty pick, and they go even early game, and now they're going to try to go late game. They've got the heroes for it. Anti-Mage, one of the best late games.
Yep, that he is. The Russian crowd's now going to go nuts because finally the Russian commentators are over on the PA system. Kaka's keeping as much information as he possibly can on the rest of OG moving through that Radiant jungle. Keep tabs on everything he possibly can. This allows KP to come a little bit further forward, but then again, KP may be a little bit too far forward. This boulder comes out from Crit, but it's a little bit too short, so KP blinks into the trees. The Sunray will be there, but they can't get a disable to stop the TP out in time.
Yeah, he's easily gone there. Only thing that could have stopped maybe is maybe AM. Bounty's doing a great job. He's 2-1-8, scouting out some heroes and things like that, but Newbee's on the back foot. They're a little unsure what to do. They do smoke two heroes, though.
Yeah, they're coming towards the mid. It's the information they got from Kaka. They know that No-Tail is fairly much alone because Kaka is in between the tree line, so they just have to get close enough to slow him down. He's now back behind the T1 and move. This is very aggressive. With the back of the haste rune, he jumps in. Fly is already to the front line, down a little bit lower, but move. You're in too deep. The Sunray will burn and he will actually die. Now Crit jumps in further. They still got that Sunray burning on Chorn, who throws away the Earth Spirit. It's a good cooldown, which may stop the aggression from OG, but it's not stopping Miracle, who really is the embodiment of aggression right now for OG.
Fly had a Supernova there. There was a cooldown that would have killed him with the second missile, so completely standard that he did that, and they win a great fight. I mean, Newbee is clearly feeling pressured. They're doing aggressive things that aren't quite paying off. Said, we've got to kill this guy now. This is our opportunity. But by the time they got in, all of their heroes were there. All of OG was there to back him up. Sunray on Viper. They can't kill this guy. It's actually almost impossible at this stage.
It's unbelievable. Like, Newbee right now are the ones who don't have an answer to a game.
And then they dust, they have the prediction dust on Moon. The kick will come and Unkaka's gonna go down.
He does buy out before he goes down at least, but track isn't paying off. It hasn't been paying off for a while.
Maybe that's what we have to start thinking about for NewB as well. The risk that OG has and the chance that NewB has to come back. Track has brought many teams back from the brink. KP, however, this kind of stuff doesn't help. 2 seconds until he can blink, but 2 seconds is too long. But what if NewB can defend from high ground? What if you have all these tracks?
I mean, can they defend high ground is the problem. Like, Viper is probably going Scotty here, maybe Ags. Can they stop him from just hitting buildings? They have some counter push, like Rubick, maybe flat cannon, call down, breathe fire. But that's about it. It's not mm-hmm. the best counter push from NewB. They're really about mobility and team fighting, but their heroes won't scale as well.
OG are going to keep the pressure up. Don't give NewB space to actually get back. There's still multiple tracks on the heroes and bot. And Chuan, oh, he really wants to find one. He picks up Notao, drags him back, but where's the follow-up? Kaka walks underneath the sentry ward. Now they dust as well. Fresh sentry down too. Kaka tries to retreat back out, but they turn on the magnetize. And Kaka, he's going to fall pretty quickly. Moves still in dragon form, feeling confident to fight, but then he gets hit by the fiber strike, and that confidence will just fade, just like his HP. The DK's down. Miracle goes further. He just wants more blood, and he's looking for Chuan, but Chuan again still in blink, away to safety. But you're losing heroes left, right, and center, and now OG, they're really going to start claiming more and more map control, and we're only 20 minutes in.
Yeah, NewB's damage is just not very good here versus things that are magic resistant, and OG picked the two heroes that do that, Viper and AM, and he's gone the super tanky build, and now NewB's just, again, not getting kills. As long as Viper's far in the front and the supports are in the back, they can cover their cores, and this is exactly how OG's been playing all week. Tanky cores, supports to back them up, it doesn't have to be IO Dazzle, Phoenix works great, if not better. So they're making it work and they're keeping their cores alive and they're punishing NewB when they think that their opponents are out of position.
One of the biggest things I remember hearing, and like there's been a lot of talk also over on forums, over on Reddit, about like who is the team that can actually bring down NewB. And OG was the one which was flagged probably higher than most, primarily because they've just been looking a lot better. They look like they've got that same purpose they had back at the Frankfurt Major, and they're bringing it into this game. Yeah. Everything just works and they're prepared against their opponent. Of course, they did have a lot of games to look back over and check and see, hey, how is NewB playing this? Study him properly.
I think they're also the team with some of the most discipline in the game, easily. They have these strats that pretty much revolve on not messing up what you're doing. Five-man pushing, fight for extended periods of time, don't have positioning errors that lead to free kills. And they do execute this very, very well compared to a lot of teams. I think it seems clear that they've at least outpicked NewB, or at least forced them into the strategy they wanted to play. But they're also outplaying it as well. And you can see the cracks. NewB's making mistakes, they're the ones that keep dying. And now Dragon Knight's not going to scale as well as even the hero like Viper.
And life is even harder too. The Aghanim Scepter's over on Moon. So now Vision Advantage also goes the way of OG with a fresh gem. Kaka, he's going to be in trouble. There's your Icarus dive forward. Let's him have the Vision up on the high ground and goodbye, Kaka.
And that's basically what Night Stalker does now. All of that advantage that Bounty has, it's gone. If he ever gets close to where Night Stalker is, instant kill. Because they're going to see him and they're going to chase him down easily. So Bounty's screwed now. He can't put wards aggressively because they're going to see it high ground. Doesn't matter where it is unless he puts it in a really untraveled place.
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to be able to get vision. He can get tracks off, but until he gets something like a blink dagger, this is just always a threat.
Moon's dead.
They might get moved.
Yep. Through the smoke maneuver, Moon doesn't have any idea anyway. It's the Aghanim's upgrade of Moon that just sees all. And then Moon, the kick will be there. Miracle jumps in. And right now, how do you kill off the dragons? Well, I think the secret's going to be that you can toggle all you want, though. You've still got three heroes around you. With an extra halves for Miracle's Mana Star, which is also completed.
They're doing it, man. The only way that this anti-mage build isn't good is that he doesn't have nearly as much mana as he would with the Battle Fury.
Oh, Chuan. Okay, he can still blink. He's still got that anti-mage blink inside of him.
Good steal. Let's see. Is Viper finished here? Is it? Oh, it is going to be Axe. Okay, cool. This build is definitely out of favor, but it lowers your ulti cooldown down to 12 seconds, which means that you can cast it a lot more. And longer range also. Very, very good spell against Dragonite, really.
Mm-hmm.
And Gyrocopter as well goes through BKB. So now Gyro has to get BKB to stop all the magic damage. And they can still permanently lock him down 5 seconds out of 12. This guy's going to be slowed by up to 80% once he hits 16 on Viper. Great item for keeping them immobile and forcing kills on Dragonite and the Gyro. I just don't see him winning this game.
Goodbye. He thought he had space to farm. This is actually the funny thing too, like, when NewB have been in this position before, they just try and create space. Normally this space is created by their support heroes. They go around, like, you have heroes like Lime with this magical burst damage of Finger of Death, and you're able to get these quick picks that then buy just that little bit of space for NewB to be efficient on their two cores of both Howl as well as Mu. But that just hasn't happened, and even when Howl and Mu actually combine themselves together, they're still not the all-powerful force we've seen previously.
I mean, we see them moving around the map, they still got that going for them, but every time it happens, it's basically OG casting spells on them, and they have to get out, or they die.
Yep.
And that's because they're so far behind, and because OG is 5-manning a lot, so the supports can't move across the map and do what they normally do. And in the meantime, the cores stand in positions that force the newbie cores to not be able to take tactical advantages.
OG's coming for their first Roshan.
Oh, I love what Fly did here. He's going on the high ground, he can still pipe the people in the pit, and he has the easiest egg ever. If they're not able to track Fly right now, for example, like if they track Fly right now while he's lower ground, and then he tries to egg on the high ground, they might see where he goes.
Yep.
But now, all of a sudden, they're going to be like, am I taking burning damage? They won't be able to tell.
Newbee, you're coming. The downside of this OG lineup, they don't have a lot of damage. So Roshan is not healthy, but Crit, he's going to break the smoke. He's over on the hillside. He'll boulder himself away. Chuan wants to jump, and he gets instantly kicked as well. They'll jump up. Crit gets the magnetized off. The rest of OG will move too, but Howl's in a good position from behind. They need to get rid of that Nova Egg. Mu and Howl trying to combine to get rid of it, and they've actually managed to do it. Fly will go down, but you still sacrifice your DK, but you've taken two. This is the best fight the newbie has had, and it's still a disaster. Howl can't even TP out. The Void will cancel that one. And they'll go back to what they started here, OG, trying to take out that Roshan.
That was great positioning by Crit. I think I would have liked him rolling southeast instead of west and using a boulder as well, because he kind of forced his team to do this like overreach team fight, which led to both supports dying pretty fast. If he could have gone down, at least then OG could have held the Rosh area, and perhaps it still was a great fight for OG. They still get Rosh, it's worth it. Kind of a weak nitpick anyways. Still a big win for OG here.
Yep. They hold their advantage and they can keep pressuring. They do not give NewB breathing room. Like, they've hit over 10k XP. Kaka is now resolved. Like, he's at least finished up the mech. But he's inside the Radiant jungle trying to farm this up. But Moon is here. He's got the Gem of Truth. Like, Kaka might be okay because it's the daytime. And Kaka actually just stops moving.
He didn't even have a TP there.
Yep.
I don't know. I mean, it's very unfortunate that he happened to walk into Nightstalker, the one guy with the gem, but he needed to not get caught like that. He basically just traded his life for a little bit of information and a creep, which is almost worth it there. I mean, at least Gyro did kill the Phoenix in the last fight. It wasn't completely wasted.
Yep. He actually got, he must have got some decent money from that too, because now he's finished up the SMY 26 minutes in.
Yeah, if you're alive for two of the kills in the fight, it's pretty solid. But as his BKB gets lower and lower, it's getting harder and harder.
He's only burned the 10-second BKB for now, but you know OG are going to force him into more fights to use it. But having both BKBs over on the Gyro as well as Mu, is that enough strength then? The newbie can at least head-to-head fight against OG?
Well, the BKB definitely helps a lot. It's pretty good, honestly. It'll be a decent solution, but the problem here is if you can't press your BKB, you're screwed. And OG's about to get the best counter to that. The Blink Abyssal Anti-Mage. Like, he's going to get initiated on, he's going to get Abyssaled, and they're going to Sunray on top of that. There's a really high chance that he gets bursted down before he activates BKB, as long as OG gets to fight start the fight. And they've got the perfect hero for it, Nightstalker.
Yep. They see everything. They always take a fight with the best advantage. NewBee preparing themselves to defend their Tier 2 tower now. As Miracle is bearing down, and I say preparing, they're abandoning. Like, there is no reason to hold the front position. They have to wait until they fight inside their base. It's almost when we have to start looking at buybacks, who's really got them. At this point, it's only the DK, and even then, maybe he actually can't save up his money. He actually buys his full BKB. They need to be ready to fight OG right here, right now.
Yeah, they have to be ready right now. So OG takes the tower, they're prepping for high ground, at least Howl gets mid, but... Alright, they're gonna play it a little safe, I guess. A little bit of D-warding. They didn't necessarily have to go high ground, I mean, they're winning all their fights, they have tons of better ganking options than their opponents.
Yep.
Perhaps just safer as a whole.
You just wait for the fights, wait for the kill.
Yeah.
And just get some good warning up, because right now NewBee, like they're trying to re-establish vision control, and they just don't have it. And it's gonna, like that one ward that they did put near the top, like the mid-river, it's gonna go down as we hit nighttime in a couple of seconds. So Moon will just clean this map up, and NewBee will have to start fighting blind. And Kaka, well, you're in this position before, man. You just hit nighttime and Moon is on the hunt.
Well, most important thing is he just scouts out cores and stuff. Oh, he's gonna show.
Yeah, he shows. Attempts the TP out. Not gonna be successful.
He's so far behind that they don't even need to interrupt his TP. They just kill him right away.
Yep.
That was so much damage. All right, there's the smoke. They get everybody but No-Tail. Nicely done there, since he was tracked. And No-Tail going for a stat build. Probably gonna be a Scotty here. Tons of utility, tons of HP. Decent damage, maybe a little bit weak, but that's basically what his team needs.
Mm-hmm.
Miracle can do the damage. He just needs to stay alive. And they're going to break smoke on
KP. KP blinks down the tree line. Boom, we'll still see him. Void will cancel the TP out. They actually instantly use the Abyssal as well. So there's no KP. The bounty has managed to respawn because he's a level 8 bounty hunter 28 minutes into this game. Kaka has had, like, the worst time ever.
Well, he had great KD at the start. Now he's basically sacrificing his life to predict where OG's moving.
Yep.
And at some point you have to do that because it's better for him to die than it is for the rest of his team to die.
Because he's not worth as much.
That as well. And yeah, the cores have to keep scaling. If Bounty keeps scaling, it's not that big of a deal. Bounty's not going to be a solution against Viper. But maybe, just maybe, if they can find some support kills using heroes like Queen of Pain or Bounty, then they could hypothetically delay the game, maybe take a good fight, get back into it.
Moon? He sees Kaka. He also sees Moon over on the side. His Viper was too far away.
Yeah, if his team was there, he definitely would have tried to force BKB on Dragonite and gone high ground.
Defense time's gonna come in a moment. Hounds actually doesn't have TP back yet. It's 7 seconds until he can return to home. Luckily, the fortification will buy a little bit of time, so Hal gets as much farm as he can from this save point. He's now up to 3.1k gold.
This ward's actually paying off on the left side. Alright, they'll get it right now, I think.
That's the first TP back. Chris, the first one to come home.
Alright, so they stopped the split push. I think they went back basically because Dragonite ulti got used. DK ulti gets popped, they back off, they defend the split push the lanes, and then they're gonna go back again. They have a 55 second window. 55 seconds that they can go for when Dragonite ults down. They scan it, they see that they're leaving the base, and this is when they're gonna turn things around. They're in great position to catch Bounty, but Viper went to the low ground, so now they know the OG's sitting in the jungle.
Yeah, and NewBee instantly moved back home. Defend from base, you know there is no more Aegis the Immortal up, it just got reclaimed as well. So NewBee back inside the base, notice who what Hal's building for. He's picked up that Eagle Song, so looks like he's gonna try and get the Butterfly up and running.
It's good.
But Miracle's farming so quickly, he can just buy an MKB.
Eventually, yeah. I mean, he's not farming as fast as he normally does. He doesn't have Battle Fury, but with a couple kills or a couple teamfight wins, yeah, he will get that MKB very rapidly. And it's not even bad, because he doesn't have that extra item slot where he has Battle Fury. Like, in an item or two, his build is gonna look completely normal for an AM, relatively. Except for the Battle Fury missing. Level 17 on him, and here comes the creep wave. They're ready to go.
Yep. Time to go high ground. Also time for Kaka to get as many tracks up as possible, make every single kill worth it. At this point, the only one he can keep on retracking is No-Tail. There's Mu, has to take the front lines too. At least got Dragon Blood to repair a lot of the damage that's done, but it's No-Tail, Aghanim, Scepter, Viper Strike. Like,
yeah.
It's just gonna keep coming and coming and coming.
I love this Dragonite Rubick combo. Both of them reduce damage. 35 hero damage reduction from Fade Bolt. And Breathe Fire does 35%, so Viper actually does no right-click damage. It's actually a quite good counter. And nukes the creep wave, and then him sieging the buildings does very little also. But they're going to try to go high ground here.
Yep. No-Tail still going to get hit by the rocket, even though we try to get rid of it. And actually, in the back lines, they smoke up. So Kaka and Chorn are currently smoked and allows Chorn to blink forward. They pick up No-Tail with the Sonic Wave! It blew out the wrong way! No-Tail almost surviving through all of this. You've still got House BKB going to work. They're now focusing over on Flying Nova, and they get it in time. Miracle, lockdown, controlled. He's so low, he's down! They brought down three! OG try and take the high ground. They haven't got the tier 3 tower. They've lost multiple heroes. Track involved as well, and now crit as well. Kaka, give him the time to get the track off. He threw it out. I don't know if it hit it in time, but either way, four heroes down from OG. And NewBee will now claim a second wind.
That was a 5.7k gold swing plus another 1,000 for the Earth Spirit dying. What a ridiculous fight from NewBee. It all basically came down to the Sunray being used on the creep wave before. If they had that, he could have possibly kept Viper alive, but it was on cooldown. So he wasn't, all he had was mech. When you lose all that HP on Viper, you need a percentage-based heal or something like that, and they just didn't have that.
The crazy thing is that also happened without Sonic Wave hitting a single hero.
Yeah, that's a good point. I don't even know if the pipe went off on Viper either, but they threw him so out of position that they were able to focus him entirely, and because they killed him,
and he was dying. He had a supernova to try to save him,
yep.
And then that meant Viper died, and then the supernova dies. It was like worst case scenario for OG there, and it all came down to the super or the sunray being misused.
I've now got this, like, what you're talking about before, with like the whole, like, you slow down the damage by having breathe fire as well as fade bolt. You've now got to pull the butterfly over on the gyrocopter, so now you got to add evasion to it. It was looking good for OG. If they took that mid rush, you'd have a large injection of money, and Monkey King bar wouldn't be a hard thing to do. Now, maybe the Animage can do it with a little bit of space, a little bit of time to farm up, but this Viper, he doesn't really have the same option.
Yeah, and the Anti-Mage items aren't going to fall into his lap like they normally do with a Battle Fury, so he's got to get that item, basically. I mean, they blew up the first hero right away, I believe. Looks like yep. Rubick was the first to die, but right after they got Viper, and that is not going to be a good trade. And
it was a Chorn initiation. Like, he had to take it for the team, right?
Yeah,
like, you jump
definitely.
In, you throw your combo, and you just get the hell out. He can buy back if required.
And that's the other problem on Anti-Mage with this build, is that your damage actually isn't very good. You're hitting for 147 plus 30. He's got a DD now, that still looks good. But if you're not bashing, then AM's damage is quite weak. So if they BKB or if your Manta's not up, your damage isn't there. You get most of your damage from the Mana Drain and the ult, and that only works on one character. So they have a very limited window. Because those two heroes are going to BKB, which means the Mana Void doesn't even do AoE damage like it normally does. So this build isn't as good when it comes to right-click damage or split push.
You had other problems as well. Like, you kept that Bounty Hunter down for so long. Now he's level 11. Now Track actually means more. But he also finished off a Solar Crest to go along with that mech. OG are going to have a hard time maintaining control in these fights, especially also as Hal now. You could be looking to have a second life over on him. This is now Roshan going the way of Newbee, and OG will not arrive there in time. Smoke movement speed bonus or not, Newbee are out.
All right, they're going to go back to the base, I guess.
Yeah.
Battle some more, maybe try to take some fights. I mean, AM doesn't have any new items here. Actually, something coming on Curry. What do we got? The No-Tail Scotty is finished. So he's got that, an extra... That's like 600 HP, couple armor points. It's pretty good to have. They gotta have the Sunray on the back of it.
Yep.
And Pipe of Insight will also help a lot from Phoenix. Shiva's Guard will make a huge difference, actually. He's getting kind of close. He did get a Midas super early. So if we're talking about like ultra late game scenarios, and that's definitely looking where this game's gonna go now because OG didn't get that Rax.
Yep.
It's still looking good for OG. That's the best thing about teamfight heroes. They're always going to scale going into the late game, almost always. Even somebody like a Tidehunter, for example, if you get the jump. Versus Newbee, they've got Rubick, who's pretty much always going to be good. Co-op's going to be okay, but her farm is nowhere near where OG's cores are. And right now, she's basically all invested on not dying. Yule Scepter Drum. So I feel like OG is going to scale better, but...
It's still going to be difficult to end the game. But the Yule Scepter Drum, yeah, not dying, but with an Aghanim Scepter, clean the wave out. Flag Cannon called down. It's not even just like making the damage lower for OG. It's the fact they can't even keep a creep wave on the high ground. The counter push is actually not as feeble as I thought it was for Newbee. And now they group up as five. They're coming for the tier 2 tower. They got Aegis the Immortal. They want OG to fight into them. They're feeling confident.
I think the only way that the OG can go high ground with one creep wave is they have to pipe the creep wave, and then they have to go high ground. But then you don't have pipe for the fight, they'll wait for pipe to go away, then they'll go in. So it's kind of a big loss there. But they need creeps to tank. The Viper isn't the best tank here. He kind of works, but his damage doesn't compensate for his tankiness. So it just takes too long.
How far could Newbee go with this? Right now, there's no defense from OG. They take out the tier 2 tower. They're ready to actually come into the OG base. We're actually at a swing point where 36 minutes in, Newbee put one foot into the base of OG, and it's Hal. Well, not literally. He's flying, obviously. But Hal, they need to get him away from this. Four stops are available.
Oh, they tracked the bounty. That's pretty good. That was a huge Aether Lens coming out of Moon.
You gotta come back home though. Miracle. He's doing miracle things. He took out the tier 3 tower back in the mid lane. So Chuan's the man on the defense. He can't really do much against AM Illusions, however. That's the reason why he has Hal, but you still took out a tier 2 tower on the top lane. You did a little bit of damage to a tier 3 tower. 10 minutes ago, I didn't think Newbee would have had that in him.
Yeah, but that's what Aegis gives you. It's harder for your opponents to take the fight. And Miracle, luckily, was split pushing in the meantime. So with that, he was able to force him back. And no fight is forced. And they're going to keep this going for a couple more minutes until the Aegis goes away, and then they'll take another fight on OG's side. Again, they're scaling very well. Their items are transitioning, and Anti-Mage is now very close to MKB. Once he gets that, he's going to shred these guys if they don't have their BKBs on.
That's true, but at the same time, now you're also dealing with more armor. Moose finished up his Assault Cuirass. If KP can get that Sonic Wave, be a lot more liberal with it as well.
Chuan with a 4-staff. We've seen how NewB have used 4-staffs beautifully. Normally, they've actually had multiple 4-staffs, giving crazy positions when they combine it up with heroes like Batrider. And that's something which, like, this NewB draft is lacking a little bit, too. Like, they don't have that jump in control initiator like you get from the Batrider, like you have from something like a Beastmaster, like the most popular hero at this LAN event so far. That just doesn't exist. So instead, NewB almost want OG to come to them and have those moments like they had in the mid lane fight before.
Yeah, they definitely want an ideal fight, that's for sure. But it is hard for them to do it. Maybe a mobility item and Dragonite will change that, because at least then they could initiate with a stun on one hero, pop their BKBs, and then force OG to react. But OG, again, is good at reacting. They've got Sunray. Shiva's is done for Phoenix as well, so a lot of attack speed, so that's easily going to offset the AC that they just picked up. Oh, is that a missile reflect? Oh, hell yes.
Yep.
Watch out, NewB.
They also
the fight starts.
They also dispelled the track.
Yeah. They actually can't kill the missile. Oh. This is how you counter NewB's lineup.
Luckily, they get a whole bunch of heroes who can attack it and destroy it.
Yeah, that's.
And now NewB will smoke. They're out of vision. The line's drawn to actually loop around. So NewB. That was actually Kaka who was drawing the line to go around, but Notel's just standing here and moves, gets the sun over on Frick, and they bring it down Sonic Wave from KP. He can say goodbye to that Earth Spirit. They want more because Chuan, he has Notel's ultimate. The Lotus Orb up, he's going to reflect the rock in a moment, but Notel dies the Sunray. It's not enough. Moon will find the kill. There's no Earth Spirit. The buyback is there from the Viper. I want to keep my eyes up on this top lane, however, because there's a decent creep wave there, and Hao is coming home. They are not going to force the issue. Aegis Immortal times out in 10 seconds time, so this looks like the right decision.
Viper kind of just died fast there. I'm quite surprised about it, but Dragonite's hitting very hard. They had a lot of heroes right clicking him, and he goes down. It's mostly likely the Solar Crest. They actually have tons of minus armor right now. Solar Crest is 10, AC is 5. That's 15 of Viper's 22 armor. That's a squishy hero. It doesn't matter how much HP you have. And he's going Butterfly next, which I sort of agree with.
Yep.
But maybe he should have gone AC instead, honestly.
Hal's got enough money to buy a straight MKB now, and he's already looking for a good item choice. He saw the Talisman of Evasion in the previous fight.
Yeah, so he's going to have that right away. He's set for it. They need a Medallion ASAP on OG. That's what they have to have. And I think you put it on the Phoenix. He's sitting behind anyways. But Medallion alone, it's like a, what, 1200 gold? And that offsets 7 of all that armor. It's very low cost. They need to make sure that the Viper stays alive. Evasion is part of that, but he definitely needs a lot of armor. Once they get that, Viper is going to become difficult to kill again. Maybe not invincible, considering how much NewB's been able to farm. But it's definitely going to get them a lot closer to where they need to be.
Oh, there's Hal. So he does have the MKB up. Viper will buy a Solar Crest of his own. So
okay.
That's the choice
all
for
right.
The Viper.
I like this. It's a instant solution. It gives you both of the things I just talked about, evasion and armor.
Yep.
And you can use it offensively if nobody else is around or you're not being focused. It's kind of the perfect situation. I love this pickup, actually, the more I think about it. Because it doesn't matter who gets initiated on. It can be Viper or it can be somebody else. His gold here, this 3,000 gold, is always going to be useful.
Smoke maneuver right now from OG. They're grouping up behind Miracle.
Will they kill the ward though? They will cut it eventually.
Yeah, they
do. May notice. They do. They pick immediately.
Yeah, you can't do that. If you're gonna run this kind of stuff, like secret kind of business, you cannot leave it like a. It's almost like a crumb trail.
Yeah, but the smoke's about to end anyways.
Yeah.
So I don't think they care that much about it.
NewB was already feeling that it was off. There's like that scan. Was just more like confirmation than anything else.
They know they're there. They see Chuan. They see Dragonite. Can definitely expect the rest of them are there.
Mm-hmm. All right, so NewB hold inside the base. All the creep waves around at the moment, so the only real farm happening on the map is Miracle. And there's those range arms you're talking about, and they come at both the same time. Mu and Chuan, the DK as well as the Rubik, both buying fresh blink daggers.
That's when things get really scary, because now Chuan can take whatever spell
they're
he wants.
Coming out. They're out of range of any kind of vision. Mood triggers ulti form. They go on Miracle. Remember, Miracle was the bait. If they can get that kill, Lotus Orb can't protect it. Miracle's down. They find the kill. Mood will follow out. They've lost their vision advantage. They've lost their gem as well. The buybacks are available for both heroes. But now NewB are making a beeline straight for the mid lane. Their tier 2 tower. This not going to survive long. And thanks to that one melee creep that survived the fight, they're going to be able to push without the backdoor regeneration of OG.
Buys him an extra 30 seconds or so. I kind of liked what OG was doing there. They had mobile heroes that could catch up, but not Viper. Like, Viper, I don't even know if he got the Solar Crest off there. And they needed to keep AM alive, but he just gets focused down. And to be honest, He should have more spell shield levels at this point. There's a lot of magic nukes coming out of Newbee. Scream of Pain, Dagger, Rocket Barrage, Dragonite, Breathe Fire, all these guys do nukes. Surely a point or two more of spell shield would be worth it?
This is so smart from Newbee. They managed to get one buyback, and you can actually see move for a moment. He flinched himself like he wanted to come back to attack the tier 3 tower. Maybe they could force out the second buyback, but no. They don't count their chickens before they hatch. They go back to the side lanes. There's tons of farm to be had, and there's also new item progressions to kick into. Hal's got himself another 3.9k gold. Moo, and we actually got anything on the courier for him. Right now he's got 1.6k. You can just start building into bigger and better items on this Newbee line. Lineup, re-establish map control, plus Roshan could have spawned up. They had to keep this in the back of their minds.
I think it's pretty soon Mu goes for a MKB of his own, and it'll be a great item because it's definitely time for a damage item on Dragonite here. It'll allow him to deal with the evasion from Nightstalker, from Viper.
Yep.
And it also protects against the eventual potential Butterfly and Anti-Mage. I don't even know if Anti-Mage buys Butterfly this game.
Holy
Blink Ford!
Oh, the danger with a jump there. Nortel's in trouble. The Viper is going to go down. The health comes in from Miracle. He'll stun over on Hal, who's BKB aware of. Now we're going to the Void. So much spell damage on Newbee when the BKBs are all gone. Mu can't get rid of Flies Nova, so he'll go down as well. Two heroes on the sideline. They didn't spend all their money, so there's still buyback available here for the Newbee cause.
Dude, Newbee had such a good spot there. We killed Viper for free again. But then OG had a great supernova, and most importantly, the anti-mage.
That mana void.
Like, Gyro has a really high int gain, actually. He's got a huge int. If you drain that mana, that ult does tons of AoE damage.
All right, they're going to buy back on the Gyrocopter. He's the one with the most amount of money. They can keep it in the bank for the DK if possible. I don't know if this is really essential. You still got Sonic Wave and you still got Fade Pulse. You potentially could have held this without actually having to worry about the Gyro, but they may be more worried about Roshan.
I don't even know if he cares. He's so rich. Like, the fact that Newbee have been able to hold this game from being at that position is just mind-blowing. They've been playing so ridiculously well. Finally, OG does get a good fight in their favor, but my god, they actually have more discipline than OG has. Like, but it's clear, they've won 29 games in a row.
Oh, Moon. He can see this. Aghanim Scepter is allowing him to see Chuan, who puts down a fresh ward, so that one's not going to last that long. But Newbee are here for a primary reason. As the primary reason is, one, stopping OG from taking Roshan, and two, if they can do it themselves, they will, but there's no lifesteal over on Hal. If he actually tries to missile Roshan and block the spell shield, Moon, keeping very close eyes, they don't have everyone. Miracle is too far away for them to just start the fight. They might be able to slow it down, however.
It's so scary, they can't see.
Oh, Kaka, forced up. They've got to get him out. The cooldown's coming down from Hal. They have to let Kaka die.
They got Gem. Can they chase? He's gonna blink forward, he gets him.
Miracle jumps on Hal. Chuan needs to make more space. Fly comes in as well. There's no Nova available. 5 seconds till it's off cooldown. Moo, no Dragon Form as well. 1 second till he's got that one. He's already triggered the BKB. I think he realized he's dead. There's no way to survive for this. So Moo is down, no buyback money. And KP caught in the bottom lane. Your Scepter up into the air, trying to get the blink away to safety. He's able to get the blink. Also with a stolen one from Chuan, he can get himself back to the tier 3 towers as well. So DK will drop. Roshan's still alive.
I think they can get it for sure. I mean, he can't buy back. He didn't use his ultimate at least, so he'll have that up when he's alive, but the game's still back and forth. Newbee with a miracle hold. I didn't mean to pun there, I'm sorry.
Amazing
hold by them. The fight that was almost unlosable. And now the game is back in OG's favor. Their items have kicked in, their cores are now into the point of the game where they scale best. And it's now the period of time where Gyro is outshined by so many other carries, maybe not so many, but other heroes. And the same is kind of going for Dragonite here.
There is one thing though. There is one thing which might be able to actually bring Gyro to the front lines again. He's holding onto the Demon Edge for now, and I tell you, it's not a Daedalus, it's a Rapier. If he can get that, these quick pickoffs, which like Newbee have been able to find through the wonderful work of Chuan, might be able to do some work for KP.
Oh,
they forced off him away, so we can Yule Scepter up and then blink away to safety. Chuan, he's all over it. He's keeping them out. House still got Fly Cannon as well as called out of Bubble Miracle, focusing on the Rax. We're 47 minutes in. It looks like for the first time, this Rax will actually get to go down.
DK's fortification up,
slows it. Yep, DK's in. The TP forward. The kick comes in. It's a little bit too early. Moose TP was actually heavily delayed. But you take the melee Rex. How much more does OG want to get?
I think they're going to stay around. I mean, they only got the melee, but their heroes are here. Why not take the fight? All their other lanes are in perfect position as well. The longer they delay, the more pressure on other lanes it happens. So they're going to try to get a pick.
Rax down. Newbee want more time. They still want to bring in the next wave of items. No G. They're not going to let him do it. Miracle, Kaka keeps tracking himself thanks to that Lotus Orb, but he wants to keep Miracle lit up like a Christmas tree. How long can you hold onto your ultimate? Not much longer, this move, he's triggered hit, they jump in, Miracle wants Howie so low, forced up into the tree line, he's got no mana, and the BKB stops the spill mana point damage from going to work, he'll get back, the Nova is down, the tier 3 tower will fall with it, but Newbee, they're going to try and reset, they're going to try and come back into this fight, move versus no tail on the front line. Your Sonic Wave off cooldown, 20 seconds time, so don't have spill damage yet. The kick!
Oh,
three
for
Crit! He catches them! Miracle jumps in two with the clean damage! The broad down two! This could be it right now! Howl's on the rope! KB's got no damage, and Howie's down! No buyback for the two big cards of GG! The streak will be ended by OG! It looks like they fell over the hurdle when they went up that mid lane to try and take out the Rax, but it's not going to be the case. It is going to be the Newbee streak ended by OG, but this is only game number one of this best of three.
That was, Newbee played that disgustingly well considering the position they were in, and they came back so much. Look at that swing. That's like a 16k gold swing in a game that looked absolutely over. They took it so close, but in the late game, OG was just outmaneuvering them a little bit in those fights. So, great strategy to counter the team that looked unbeatable. They played amazing, and they